Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to this playlist where I'm covering how to prepare for JavaScript interviews. Okay, so in this video we are going to talk about how to build your profile. So we have to first build our profile to get a proper or get a better job. So what are the different options using which you can build your profile? So first basic requirement is you should have a nice and clean resume which is reflecting on the core skills which you have, on all different projects which you have worked on, and what all technologies you are aware of or you have worked on. Okay, this is the first thing. So first we will talk about how to write a clean and clear resume. So there are different templates available. I will suggest you to use these templates. These are the shared latex template. You just like this particular template may be the nice one. And what this template is, you can just download the PDF. So here you can put your experience proper formatted way. You can put your technologies, all the work which you have done. These kind of resume can be helpful either you are a beginner or either you are an intern or you are already having good amount of experience. It doesn't matter. These set of templates are very good, which is covering your all GitHub, LinkedIn, Twitter, all the social profile links if you wanted to add your information, your names and your summary about your profile, and then you can add your work experience, academic informations, honors, awards, certifications, all these things you can add. The only thing which you need to take care is you should avoid repetitions and try to cover all of your resume in two pages. If you are a beginner or intern, then don't create a 2 or 3 page resume. Just 1 page resume is more than sufficient, because what you should focus is first section is what all you have worked on, your projects, your awards, certifications, your academic. That's it. 4 sections can be accommodated in a 1 single page. If you are experienced, you have worked on multiple organizations, then it is fine. You can give a 3 different sections for individual organizations and in 1 whole section which covers all of your technologies you have worked on. If you wanted to put more information like a whole page for your project about in a 1 organization, then it will become lengthy and you will have a 5 to 6 page resume which nobody will read and nobody will understand. If interviewer is taking your interview, he will just look at your resume for 1 or 2 minutes to get highlights out. Okay, you have worked on these things, these technologies, these kind of projects you have worked on. Okay, so writing a resume is very important things, and you can actually use these different templates. These templates are available, you just need to edit them properly. It's not a Word document, it's a shared latex template, so you just need to take care of the formatting and the styles which this shared latex is providing. Okay, but Once you are done with this, it's very good formatted resume which is going to be helpful for the future also. Okay, next thing is I will talk about this GitHub first, GitHub repo, projects and all. This is important because if you are giving interview, then you can give a reference of your these projects. Even you can share the links if interviewer is interested in looking into your code, your repositories, your public repositories where you have worked on a couple of projects, right? That will give an idea about your experience, your knowledge, what kind of code you are writing, because it will not be a case every time you will be given some coding assignment then you will be submitting it. But if you already have some repositories where you have done a good number of commits, you made a good application, then you can share those links. The interviewer will look at your code, your commit stylings, your PR if you have made to any open source projects. That will be helpful to give an idea, okay, what kind of contributor you are. It's not like you should be contributing to open source project, you are building your own project with your colleague or by yourself, for yourself, okay. Then you should be writing blog somewhere. It's not necessary that you should write on the Medium. You can have your own channel, your own website, or you can just use these platforms. So there are many platforms available. like dev.to. This is the platform where you can sign in using GitHub and you can start building your building the blogs. I mean, you start writing and publishing the blogs on the knowledge whatever you have. That this is the medium where you can showcase your expertise in a particular topic, in a particular technology. Okay, regarding GitHub, GitHub has now started providing this README. README is giving us a good introduction about your what you do in terms of technologies, what all technologies you are working on, what all kind of projects you are working on. All this information is given. Okay, what all you do, all these informations can be captured from this GitHub README file which recently added, and your repositories, your projects you can add, and if you have published some package for the GitHub, you can just add that here. Okay, apart from that, if you already have your own website, that is good, otherwise it's fine, it's not optional, it's not like you need to, you must have this. Okay, sometimes people have their own portfolio kind of web app where they actually showcase their talent. They contain their resume, they contain their profile, their experience. It's a kind of a resume they put as a profile on their own website. Okay, LinkedIn, if you are an intern or very beginner, skip LinkedIn. But if you are very much experienced, then you have to clean up your profile. Sometimes interviewer will also look at your LinkedIn profile to see what all kind of projects in depth detail you can get from the LinkedIn profile, your contacts and all. Okay, so these things, and if you are experienced, then obviously you should have a good number of repositories, not in terms of count but in terms of work. Okay, you may be doing some kind of open source contribution, and if you have good knowledge, then you can also publish your own blogs. Can be a WordPress blog, can be a Moody Medium blog, can be a blog on any different channel. We have like 1,000 different channels where you can publish your knowledge in terms of blog. Okay, so this is the basic baseline I'm trying to create before preparing you for the interviews, that these are the basic things which you should cover. The rest all is your technical knowledge, because these things will help you to get shortlisted. Next phase is facing the interviews, writing the code, writing the pseudo code, writing the data structure code and all, writing the JavaScript utilities which interviewer is asking. Okay, top interview questions you will get familiar soon. Okay, thanks everyone. So from the next video, we'll start talking about data structure and algorithm. First we will talk about basic data structures. Okay, then we will cover different algorithms using those data structure in JavaScript.